Hi, I'm Lisa Kelly, and I'm one of the soloists with Celtic Woman. Well, I was 7 when I first started to sing. I came from quite a musical background. Both my parents sang, and they met each other through amateur dramatics. So they had us all singing by the time we were 7, and then I learned to play the piano. And I just continued singing then throughout school. I have a huge range of music in my background. As I said, I've started in musicals and was trained classically and did a little bit of opera. But I think my heart was always with musicals until I went to Riverdance, and then I sort of started to discover the traditional side of Irish music and started breaking into that. And now that's become probably my first love. I think Celtic Woman was so diverse. There was just so much choice of music within the show itself, and it was wonderful to be part of something like that, because it's always nice to go out and sing what you know, but when you go out and you sing what you know and it's also part of your heritage, it's a lovely feeling.
May it be
take on something like May It Be, which is from a huge movie. You know, Lord of the Rings was so popular here and in the States and all over Europe. To be able to do a movie theme in a show as a singer is just fantastic.
Send Me
a Song was written by David Downes, who was actually our musical director on the night, and he had written this song I think 4 or 5 years ago, and I had recorded it for my own CD, and when he asked me to sing it for this show, I was so thrilled, because it's such a beautiful song, and again it's a lovely modern contemporary song with the little bit of Irishness in it, so it was lovely to sing it, and I actually got to sing it with him playing the piano, which was just fantastic.
Forget when you're missing me so. Love must never hold tight, but let go. We'll find a way of forgiving somewhere.
Somewhere from West Side Story. I mean, I've done the show twice, and I played Maria both times, and it's always been sung as a duet, and very often you're asked to sing somewhere, you know, even at funerals and things like that. People really want to hear that song. It's such a beautiful, beautiful song, and I remember hearing that it was actually going to be in this show, and then when I heard it was in 4-part harmony with absolutely no music, that's just a huge task to take on, and I was really worried as to whether it would sound really well, because it should be one of those that you can hear a pin drop in the audience, and it did. It was just amazing. The harmonies were just fantastic. I was so worried about the costumes for the show. I just wasn't sure how I was going to look 4 weeks after having a baby, and I was so scared of what they were going to put me in. I thought I'd still be in a maternity dress, but Sian and O'Mahony designed our dresses. And when I just saw my dress, I couldn't believe it. It was exactly, if I had to pick out something for myself, it would exactly be what I would pick out. It was stunning, absolutely stunning. Before Celtic Woman, I'd never met any of the girls in the show. I was actually surprised how well everybody interacted. You know, sometimes it's hard to have soloists come together and do a show together, but the girls were great and we had a great time. As a soloist, sometimes it's hard to blend with other voices, but the way the music was arranged, I think it made it even easier for all of us to sound well together.
Why do they speak so selfishly when we have got so much we can share?
I just recorded my own DVD to go with my CD that I've recorded, and we recorded that a couple of weeks ago up in Castle Leslie in Monaghan, and we just basically did all the songs from the CD, put them on DVD, and now we're planning my next CD. I'd still like to do a few more traditional songs. I think there's lots out there now, and as I'd said, you know, there's so many new composers coming online now and making traditional songs sound modern and making Irish songs sound modern, which had never really happened before. So I'd like to stick with a lot of the Irish songs and maybe throw in a few musical numbers here and there.
One bright star.